Hello and welcome. It's the Champion of Champions final here on Countdown. And I can tell you, you can cut the atmosphere in here with a knife, and it would not need to be a sharp knife either. Talking about finals, it was on this very day back in 1969 that the Beatles made their final appearance together on the roof of Apple Records in London. Now, some might say that I am the walrus of this programme, but I'll tell you what, she can work it out. It's Rachel Riley.
I like that one.
Rachel, go on, who was your favourite? John, Paul, Ringo, George? You don't know what I'm talking about, do you?
Oh, the Scouse one.
All Scouse ones. They're before you. What's on your iPod now, then? Come on,
all
tell us.
All kinds of stuff. I've got Jackson 5, U2, Jack Johnson, Kaiser Chiefs, anything you can think of.
No, oh, heard of one or two of those, I think, somewhere along the line. We started off with 16 elite countdowners. Now we're down to two. And just continuing that theme, I can tell you, they have not needed any help from anybody on their way to this final. They've been absolutely fantastic. Let's meet them both right now. First of all, Steve Bryars. Steve has made it all the way to the Champion of Champions final with some outstanding play over the last 3 weeks. We saw him in action in his semi-final on Wednesday. He battled it out against the sports betting analyst, Nick Wainwright. Steve spotted some amazing words like Lazarus and annelids and racked up a score of 87 to Nick's 82. Steve's an A-level student from Southampton and a 2006 Octochamp and Series 55 quarter-finalist. This is his last game. He's hoping to end his countdown experience on a high and win the Champion of Champions title. Steve, how are you feeling?
A little bit relaxed, actually, rather surprisingly.
Best of luck to you. I don't know if that's bad news or not for your opponent today, who's Charlie Reams. Now, Charlie is a PhD student at Cambridge University who also runs an internet forum on all things countdown related. So who better to have in the Champion of Champions grand final? Yesterday, we watched his magnificent performance in the semi-finals against top player John Corby. He picked out words like Dolomite, Rubicons and failures. Failures? Hardly. He stole the game with a score of 110 to 76. Charlie was the runner-up from the last Countdown series in December, so is hoping to do one better and become Countdown's Champion of Champions today. The very best of luck to Charlie Reams and Steve Bryars. And over in Dictionary Corner, Susie Dent is there, and we're guaranteed a magical mystery tour, aren't we, because Paul Zennon's alongside.
How are you doing?
Paul, it's been great having you all week. We've had some fantastic tricks from you. You saved the best to last.
Kind of. Yeah, I'm not going to give anything away, actually, but it'll be an interesting one way or the other.
Looking forward to that. Okay, here we go with the grand final in our Champion of Champions contest. And the toss has been won by Charlie. So, Charlie, it's your first pick of letters.
Hi, Charlie.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Can. Very best of luck to you both. P.
And another.
J.
And another.
L.
And another.
N.
And a vowel.
E.
And another.
U.
And another.
O.
And a consonant.
T.
And a final vowel, please.
And the last one. Another O.
So for the first time in the final, let's start the countdown clock. Steve, what have you come up with?
Seven.
Seven. Charlie?
No, just six.
Six, OK. What's your six, Charlie?
Lepton.
OK. And Steve?
Opulent.
Lovely. Very, very good indeed. Well done.
And that's the sort of standard we've seen for 3 weeks now. It's just amazing. Let's have our next letters game. And Steve, it's your pick this time.
Hello, Rachel.
Afternoon, Steve.
Can I start with a consonant, please?
You can. P.
And another.
T.
And another.
W.
And another.
Y.
And a vowel, please.
U.
And another.
E.
And another.
O.
A consonant.
L.
And a final consonant, please.
And to finish, C.
And time starts now. Charlie, how many?
Seven.
Seven, Steve?
And seven.
What's your seven then, Steve?
Couplet.
Couplet, yeah. And your seven, Charlie?
Octuple.
Octuple.
Octuple, yes, consisting of eight parts. We had octonary the other day, so lots of eight things, but that is there for seven, ironically. That's fine.
OK, let's move on to our next letters game. Charlie, your pick this time.
Could I have a consonant, please?
Yeah, thank you, Charlie. M.
And another?
D.
And another.
B.
And another.
Another D.
And a vowel.
A.
And another.
U.
And another.
Another A.
And another.
I.
And a final consonant, please.
And lastly, F.
And your time starts now. Steve, how many?
Only five.
Five. And Charlie?
Yeah, just five.
Just five. OK, what was your five, Charlie?
Mafia.
Mafia. OK, and
yeah, I had the
same thing.
Lovely.
Not a great collection of letters. I mean, I got daub for four, and I'm thinking, I'm patting myself on the back there, you know, but...
Nothing to beat that, five.
No, well done, you.
Absolutely. So Steve has 19 points at the moment, and Charlie has 12. And Steve, your choice of letters.
Consonant, please.
Let's start with L.
And another.
N.
And another.
R.
And one more.
M.
A vowel, please.
E.
And another.
A.
And another.
O.
A consonant.
N.
And a final vowel, please.
A final I.
And here's the countdown clock. So, Charlie, what did you manage to come up with?
Seven.
Seven. Steve?
Seven also.
OK, Steve, what's your seven?
Mineral.
OK, Charlie?
Manlier.
Manlier. Mineral and manlier.
Very good indeed. Yep, both of them.
OK. End in dictionary corner.
There's also melanin, the pigment in your skin. Melanin.
Steve has 26. Charlie has 19. It's time for our first numbers game. And, Charlie, it's your selection.
Could I have a good old one large, please?
Yeah, of course you can. So one and one, two, three, four, five. Let's hope it's a nice one for you. We have nine. One, three, four, eight, and 100. And the target, 659.
And you have 30 seconds to find it. Thank you. Steve, have you done?
Just 658 not written down.
658 not written down, Charlie?
Yeah, I also have 658.
Okay. Yours is written down, yeah?
Yes.
Okay, well, let's see the one that's not written down first of all, then, Steve.
Okay, 100 plus 8 plus 1.
100 plus 8 plus 1 is 109.
9 minus 3 is 6.
9 minus 3 gives you 6.
Multiply the two together should be 654.
654, yep.
And add on the 4.
And add on the 4. Yep, 658, one away.
Your method, Charlie?
Completely different. 9 minus 3 is 6.
9 minus 3 is the 6.
Take that away from the 100.
100 minus 6 equals 94.
Then 8 minus 1 gives you 7.
8 minus 1 is 7.
And then if you multiply those...
658.
And then that's what I declared.
Yeah. It's a tricky one, this one.
Yeah, well, I'm going to ask you, obviously. Can you go one better?
I can't go one better at the moment. I mean, there's a bunch of different ways to get one away, but... couldn't get the elusive 659 at the moment, I'm afraid. I'll carry on trying.
Okay. Well done, fellas. Anyway, 658. Good effort. Steve has 33. Charlie has 26 in this grand final. Paul, you promised your trick today would be interesting. I'm looking forward to sitting back and watching it.
Well, you're not really going to be watching it because you're going to be doing it, Jeff. And we've got a brand new deck of cards for you, actually. We haven't even opened the seal on this one, and you can keep this afterwards so you can practice.
I must go down as the least attractive magician's assistant ever.
You reckon? Mm. You don't remember Paul Daniels then? But let's get rid of the rule cards and the jokers from there. So we've got a brand new deck of cards there. We're giving a little mix up. Now, I'm going to leave you to do this trick on your own.
Oh, great.
Okay.
Looking forward to that.
So I'm just going to stick those in front of you. There's the box. Susie is going to kind of do the direction on this. I've got some instructions here. So basically, while Susie reads out these instructions, I'm just going to sit here and waggle my wand. So I'll be the kind of conductor. Okay, so here we go. Number one, Susie.
Cut some cards, Jeff, from the top of the deck, somewhere between 1 and 20 cards, and then put them in your pocket.
Okay, between 1 and 20. Yep. There we go. And pop them in my pocket. Okay.
From the rest of the deck, deal exactly 20 cards face down onto the table.
Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20.
Okay. Put the remainder of the deck back in the box.
Okay.
Yeah. Take the cards back out of your pocket and count how many there are. This will be your magic number.
Right, okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
Okay. Put the cards back in your pocket and now pick up the pile of cards from the table.
Okay. Pick them up.
Right, deal those cards onto the table, counting down to the one at... counting down to the one at your magic number.
Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So this is the magic card, this is number 7, there's the magic card.
Right. Now ask me what's inside this envelope.
Susie, what's inside that envelope?
What is that? No, I do this now, yeah.
Amazing. Thanks, Paul. Absolutely brilliant. I'm going to take a couple of minutes break. Our tea time teaser is Dark Mirror. Dark Mirror. And the clue said something about the corrected exam paper. Said something about the corrected exam paper. Back in a second. Said something about the corrected exam paper was, of course, remarked. Steve has 33, Charlie has 26, who will be our champion of champions. Let's have our next letters game. And Steve, it's your choice.
Okay. Consonant, please, Rachel.
So to start, N.
And another.
C.
And another.
R.
And one more.
T.
Vowel, please.
E.
And another.
A.
And another.
E.
And another.
Another E.
And a final vowel, please.
And an A.
Here's the countdown clock. Charlie, what have you found?
Seven.
And Steve?
Seven also.
What's your seven, Steve?
Reenact.
Reenact. And Charlie?
Cataran.
Cataran.
Right, I've just checked reenact because most of them have lost their hyphens, but some of them haven't. Oh, that one hasn't, Steve, I'm afraid. It has still got one. Cataran is absolutely fine.
Well, it couldn't be more superbly poised, could it, at the moment? Charlie has 33, Steve has 33, and Charlie, it's your pick of the letters.
Could I have a consonant, please?
You can, Charlie. S.
And another.
T.
And another.
R.
And another.
Another T.
And a vowel.
O.
And another.
A.
And another.
E.
And another.
I.
And a final consonant, please.
And a final G.
And your time starts now. Steve, how many this time?
Eight.
And Charlie?
Eight.
OK, what's your eight, Charlie?
Garrots.
Garrots.
And
Steve?
Toastier.
Toastier.
Toastier's lovely, isn't it? It's a lovely word, and it is in. Okay. Very good indeed.
Charlie has 41 points. Steve has 41 points. It's neck and neck. Steve, your choice of letters.
Consonant, please.
Thank you, Steve. L.
And a vowel.
I.
And a consonant.
S.
And a vowel.
E.
And a consonant.
P.
A vowel.
E.
A consonant.
R.
A vowel.
Another I.
And a final consonant, please.
A final R.
Let's start the clock. Charlie?
I'll go for an eight.
OK. A bit hesitant. Steve?
Yeah, an eight as well.
OK. Let's hear your first, Steve.
Repliers.
Repliers. Uh-huh. And Charlie?
Yep. Same word.
It is indeed.
Yeah, I checked it immediately because it was the obvious thing to go for, and it is in, so it's well done.
On to the next round. Charlie? Your pick of the letters.
Can I have a consonant, please?
Thank you, Charlie. D.
And another consonant.
Z.
And another one.
H.
And another.
N.
And a vowel.
E.
And another.
O.
And another.
Another O.
And another.
And a third O.
Better have a consonant then, please.
And S.
And time starts now. Steve, what have you come up with?
Seven.
Seven. Charlie?
Just six.
OK, what's the six, Charlie?
Dozens.
Dozens, yep. And the seven, Steve?
Snoozed.
Yes, very good. Snoozed.
Steve has 56 points. Charlie has 49. It's the grand final in our search for our champion of champions. Could go either way. Susie, it's the last show of the week. I think you're just being kind to me because of that. I think you're combining two of my favourite topics today.
I am. Bit of light relief. I was going to combine food and sport. And really, a lot of people think that there's a lot of food imagery in politics. We talk about bread and butter politics. Gordon Brown was said to go on a prawn cocktail offensive in the city. But actually, in sport, it features quite large as well. And I was just going to do some of the terms, which you'll know very well, Jeff. There's ham and egging, which is in team sports when different team members perform well at different times to produce an overall great effect, like ham and eggs. That was Michael Jordan. And then there's the famous Ron Atkinson lollipops. If a player lollipops an opponent, is that how it's used?
Yeah
then the ball goes through his opponent's legs very cleverly. And nutmeg. I know you've asked me about nutmeg before. To nutmeg a ball is to kick it through an opposing player's legs, a bit like a lollipop. And the reason for it is, and I won't linger on this too much, but nutmegs were actually very, very old slang, goes back to the 15th century for a certain parts of the male anatomy. So if you take the megs off, you'll get the idea. And that's where the idea comes from. But yeah, food and sport, they're very closely linked.
I tell you, I once played against the late, great George Best in a charity football match, and I was defending, and he came towards me, and he nutmegged me. And if it had been from anybody else, I'd have been embarrassed, but because it was George Best, I thought it was fantastic. Steve has 56 points, Charlie has 49. Here's our latest numbers game. And Steve, it's your pick.
Can I have two large and four small, please?
Oh, of course you can. So two from the top, and we'll do four from the bottom row for the second numbers game of this exciting final. So there's six, another six. 10. Oh, another 10. 25 and 50. This could be an interesting one. And 832.
And 30 seconds to reach that target. Charlie?
I think I've got 8.30.
8.30, Steve?
8.35.
8.35, OK, 8.30's closest, so, Charlie, let's hear it.
OK,
50
plus 25.
50 plus 25.
Plus the 6.
Plus the 6, yeah, that gives 81.
And then, oh no, hang on, have I gone wrong? Yeah, I have, sorry.
Well, what about that 8.35 in that case then, Steve?
Okay, 50 plus 25.
50 plus 25.
That's 75.
Is 75.
6 over 6 is 1.
6 over 6 is 1.
Add on one of the 10s is 11.
Add on the 10 here gives you 11.
That's 8.25 if you multiply.
You time the, yeah, 8.25.
And add on the other 10.
Add on the other 10. Yeah, that's sorry, 10 there. So that's three away, so 7 points. Mm-hmm. They're quite tricky today. I haven't got this one either, I'm afraid.
OK. Well done, Steve. 7 points to you, though. Here's your tea time teaser. Dart rope. Dart rope. It runs away with itself, followed by lots more. It runs away with itself, followed by lots more. runs away with itself, followed by lots more. Teardrop, of course, was the answer. No teardrops here, regardless of who wins and who loses. But we are getting close to crowning our new champion of champions. At the moment, Charlie Reams has 49. Steve Bryars has 63. Plenty of time to change that. Here's our next letters game. Charlie, it's your call.
Could I start with a consonant, please?
You can, Charlie. Start with L.
And another one.
S.
And another.
N.
And another.
T.
And a vowel.
I.
And another.
O.
And another.
E.
And another.
Another E.
And a final vowel, please.
And to finish, another E.
And here's the countdown clock. Steve, what have you got for us?
Just seven.
Seven, OK. Charlie?
Yeah, seven.
Seven. What's your seven, Charlie?
Lennites.
Lennites. Okay. Your seven, Steve?
Estoile. Not sure if that's how it's pronounced or not, but...
Yes, Lennites is absolutely brilliant. It's to do with how you pronounce consonants in a Celtic language, so well done, Charlie. And estoile, in heraldry, is a star with wavy points or rays, usually six in number. Fantastic.
Steve has 70, Charlie has 56. Here's our next letters game. Steve, it's your pick.
Consonant, please, Rachel.
Thanks, Steve. V.
And another.
M.
And another.
R.
And another.
N.
And a vowel, please.
I.
And another.
A.
And another.
Another A.
Consonant.
B.
And a final consonant, please.
And to finish, H.
And time starts now. Charlie, how many have you got?
Just six.
Six. Steve?
Six as well.
Steve, what was your six?
Marina.
Marina. And yours, Charlie?
Airman.
Airman.
Oh, one word. No problem with that at all.
Fantastic. Yes. OK, Steve has 76 points. Charlie has 62. Remember, it's the grand final in our Champion of Champions quest, and it is still absolutely anybody's. Let's press on with our next letters game. Then, Charlie, choice is yours.
Could I have an excellent consonant, please?
I will try my best. P.
Oh, that's pretty good. Could I have another one, please?
T.
And another.
Oh, sorry. Q.
Oh, better have a vowel.
I'll try harder. A.
And another.
Oh, U for you.
And another vowel.
E.
And another.
A.
And a consonant.
S.
And a final vowel, please.
A final U.
And here's the countdown clock. Steve?
Just a five.
Five. Charlie?
Yeah, just five.
OK, what's the five, Charlie?
Quest.
Quest. And Steve?
Squat.
Squat, rather like me. Anything better over there?
No, if they can only get five, so can we, and that's why we're upset. That's okay. The other five.
Here's our next numbers game. And Steve, it's your selection.
I'm going to be a bit of a coward this time and just go for inverted T, please.
Inverted T, well, that's been quite difficult for the last ones. I think upset is what I am after those numbers games. They've been nasty. But for this final round, we've got 2, 9, 7, 4, another 4, and 75, and target 874.
30 seconds to reach it. Charlie, how do we do?
No, absolutely nothing.
OK. Steve?
I've got 869 not written down.
Do you want to give it a go?
I shall say 7 plus 4 is 11.
7 plus 4 is 11.
75 plus 4 is 79.
75 plus 4 is 79.
Multiply the two together and it... I believe you get 871. No, you don't, do you?
No, you don't. You get 869, don't you?
That's what you said, 869.
In which case, hurrah.
Absolutely. You delivered what you promised. Spot on. Well, Rachel, 874.
I can give you 873.
OK, well, give us 873 then, please.
I'll give you 873. 75 times 4 is 300. Minus the 9 is 291. And then 7 minus 4 is 3. Times those together, you should get 873, but they've been horrible today. Sorry about that, guys.
Thanks very much indeed. It's Steve on 88, Charlie on 67 in this Champion of Champions contest. And we have just one round remaining, and it is the Countdown Conundrum. So fingers on buzzers, and please reveal today's Countdown Conundrum. Right at the death, Steve.
I think I've just made it up. Libouette.
Think you have just made it up.
I have, don't know.
Charlie, you'll be pleased to know you get the rest of the time. Any idea?
Is it Gandhi Sikh?
Surprisingly, no, it is not. But I'll tell you what, it has been an elite bout, hasn't it? Here's the answer to the conundrum. Oubliettes. So, commiserations to Charlie Rimm's been an absolutely fantastic contestant, and I'm sure you're beginning to be getting so many more hits on that internet forum after your performances here over the last 3 weeks.
Yes, I hope so.
But congratulations to Steve Bryars. He is the Countdown Champion of Champions. Give him another big round of applause. Steve, very well done. We've got a nice trophy for you to take home as well. Many, many congratulations. It was a terrific performance.
Thank you very much.
Thanks very much again to Susie, and thanks to Paul Zenon. You have been magical. And Rachel, thanks for suffering all my Beatles gags. You know. We'll be back on Monday with two brand new contestants who, one day, who knows, might be in our Champion of Champions quest as well. But they'll be starting off anew this coming Monday. And we've got some beautiful redesigned goodie bags and brand new teapots as well. It's going to be a lot of fun. Make sure you join us then. Bye-bye for now.
big decisions tonight. Where's best to raise the kids? Norfolk or Vegas, a place in the sun, home of USA at 8. Tomorrow night at 8, join Hugh Fernley Whittingstall on his campaign to raise poultry standards in Chickens Hugh and Tesco 2. Next today, Deal or No Deal.